Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, lovably called as Bapu, was born on 2nd October 1869 at Porbandar in Gujarat. His father was a higher official of Porbandar and his mother Putlibai was a religious woman. Gandhi was an average student, but he derived the modesty from his father and morale through his mother. Stories such as Satya Harishchandra highly influenced Gandhi to lead a principled life. At the age of 19, Gandhi went to England to become a lawyer. After returning to India, he began to practice law in Bombay with little success. So when he received an offer to work for a firm in South Africa, he was ready to oblige it. He was 24 years by the time and had a wife named Kasturibai. While being in South Africa, which was dominated by the Europeans, Gandhi often felt the discrimination against the Indians. On one such occasion, he was forced to give up his seat in the first class compartment to a European. When he refused to do so, he was beaten up by the coach driver and was thrown out of the train. This proved to be the wake-up call for Gandhi to fight against the suppression. He soon found out a way to revolt, and that's called Satyagraha, the force of truth. With the newly found Satyagraha, Gandhi was able to combat the discrimination against the Indians. He even gained them the right to vote, for which he became a national hero. In 1914, while Gandhi came back to India, the country was under the rule of the British. Gandhi immediately joined the freedom movement and called for Swaraj, the rule by our own countrymen. With the introduction of Gandhian style of non-violence and non-cooperation, the Indian freedom struggle got much powerful. In 1921, he was made the leader of the Indian National Congress, the party that was fighting for the independence. In 1930, as the British government imposed tax on the salt, Gandhi took a 400 kilometers march to seashore called Dandi. There, he made salt with his own hands to show his protest against the evil tax. He even encouraged the use of homemade khadi through an instrument named charaka. Khadi was not only aimed to provide self-dependence, it was indeed an act of rebellion against the foreign-made clothes. Gandhi not just influenced the people to be powerful and independent, he showed them the way a leader should be: calm, simple and humble. Though a religious person, always changing the names of God and reciting Bhagavad Gita, Gandhi was always against the social evils such as untouchability. With such qualities, he was rightly called as Mahatma, the great soul. Whenever his ways of non-violence has not yielded the expected results, Gandhiji resorted to the hunger strike, placing his own life in danger for the cause. As the Second World War broke out in 1939, Gandhi thought it to be the right time to force the Britishers to quit. He invoked a movement in 1942 called the Quit India Movement. By the year 1947, the British government has enough troubles to seek in India and England. So it did leave India, but only after dividing it into two countries, India and Pakistan. Though Gandhi was happy for the independence, he was shattered by the partition. The partition of India was not a peaceful process. It led to violent clashes between the Hindus and the Muslims. Gandhi repeatedly went to the hunger strikes to restore peace among the country. On one such occasion, in 1948, as Gandhi completed a two-day hunger strike in New Delhi, he was shot dead by a Hindu nationalist called Nathuram Godse. Though Gandhi was no more to lead the nation, his principles and character has always shown the best way for the leaders to follow. Gandhiji was rightly thought to be the man of the millennium.